Kelsey Nicole Nelson here on the red carpet with an actor that we've gotten to know very well over the years. Babes in Toyland, annual party, Super Bowl Sunday coming up. Yes. First off, how have you enjoyed your week thus far?
Thus far, it's been very busy and very active, and I'm enjoying myself.
As it should be. Tell me, what have you enjoyed about the party most thus far?
Well, you know what? I've just arrived, but one of the things that I'm enjoying is that there are a lot of festive outfits.
Yes.
If you can coin it in that phrase.
That's a good way to say it.
You know, there's a lot of babes in Toyland. Let's just put it that way.
This has become one of the premier parties during Super Bowl week, and I think it just shows you the fun around the games, right? Yes. I think you need the little ease before Sunday.
I agree with 100%. I'm having a great time. You know what I mean? I'm getting an opportunity to spend time with you, and it's just wonderful.
Thank you. So what have you been up to lately?
Well, I continue with the show. You know, we're in our seventh season of the show SWAT. And I play Shamar Moore's dad on that show.
Yes.
And we're in our seventh season, as I said, and we're having a great time. And this season is something special going to be happening. So please tune in.
I love that. We're going to be looking forward to it. We look forward to seeing you inside. Thank you so much for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Kelsey Nicole Nelson back here on the red carpet with Cincinnati Bengals offensive tackle Orlando Brown Jr. Orlando, how are you enjoying the night thus far?
Oh, man, it's going great. You know, I just got off a nightcap with Shannon Sharp and Chad Ochocinco, so that was a good little time I was there for them, hitting a million subscribers. Now I'm just over here walking the red carpet, mingling, hanging out.
Nice. Shannon Sharp continues to just defy the odds, right? From Monique to Cat Williams to First Take, right? A good guy.
Yeah, he got it going on, man. It seemed like every episode is a viral moment now. You know what I mean? It's crazy.
I love that. And you and Shannon Sharp have something in common, playing for the Baltimore Ravens. Yes. I know you come from football lineage.
Yes.
So what do you guys talk about, you know, when you talk about football and life?
We just touched a little bit on my dad, my story, being a left tackle, wanting to play the left tackle position, little small things like that.
Yeah. You're talking about a team in the Super Bowl. You know a little bit about the Kansas City Chiefs because you played for them. Do you think they win on Sunday?
I do. I think they got all the right pieces. They got the right focus. They got everything it takes, man. That's the reason that they're here.
Give us a little bit of insight into that culture in the locker room with the Kansas City Chiefs and why their bond seems so strong.
Yeah, well, when you spend a lot of time off the field together and you spend a lot of time getting to know the man and, you know, the wives getting to know the wives and girlfriends getting to know the wives and wives knowing the girlfriend, like, great things come out of that. And that's the culture, that's the standard. It's a family-like atmosphere there. And, you know, those type of things reflect what you see on the field.
Yeah. And talking about the AFC, you also know about the Baltimore Ravens, of course, the team that the Chiefs defeated.
Yeah.
Were you heartbroken like many fans when the Ravens didn't reach the playoff, the Super Bowl?
Like, honestly, yes. I've already seen Pat do it so many times. I was rooting for Lamar just because, and my brother Marq Andrews that plays there as well, man, the organization always looked out for me. So I really want to see Lamar get that Super Bowl. But, you know, they came up short. It sucks, man. They might have to wait another year or two. So here's what it is.
Yeah. You know about the city of Baltimore. They hosted the first AFC Championship game since 1971, Orlando. How special was that for you to watch?
So special. I thought about going, to be honest. Like, I'm still a Ravens fan down in my heart somewhere. Don't tell too many people that.
We won't get you in trouble. Let's talk about the Bengals season thus far. AFC North is pretty loaded, Orlando. So what are you hoping to build on next season?
Yeah, well, just continuity, continuing to get better each and every week. I think, you know, certain times, obviously with Joe being hurt, it had an effect on us. But, man, I mean, I think we got all the right pieces. We got the right focus. We got everything we need to do what we need to do.
You all have a quarterback that a lot of people talk about in Cincinnati, and Joe Burrow. What makes him so special?
Yeah, well, I just feel like, you know, he's an impeccable leader.
Yeah.
He does a great job in the building on a daily, bringing the best out of everybody, man. I got so much respect for him.
I love it. Yeah. Roland, are you here with your family by yourself? You have a little one at home, right?
I do. I got two little ones. So we got a three-year-old. Me and my girl have a three-year-old. And we got a six-week-old at home now. So two boys.
So this is the little break for you.
This is my little break, man. I've been sleeping my ass off.
As you should be. You had a good season.
Yes, absolutely.
So great to meet you. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Appreciate you.
Nicole Nelson back here on the red carpet with Miss Annie Agar, NFL correspondent for Stadium. First off, Annie, you're fresh from the NFL Honors. How was the event?
It was amazing. It's so fun to see all the guys together and everybody dressed up, you know, and it was a good time, for sure.
I love it. And talk about a good time. We we have a good time watching your videos weekly, your NFL team meetings. Annie, how do you prepare for those videos?
It's a lot of research. You know, I can make any joke, but I try to make the jokes that fit the fan bases and are like inside jokes. So I research for probably 7-8 hours, shoot the video for 4 hours, and editing is a whole other process. So it's a good like 24-hour process to get the video out there, but it's so worth it.
It's such good content. Thank we truly enjoy it, Annie. And this week we celebrated National Girls and Women in Sports Day. It coincided with Super Bowl. I love that, Annie. So what do you hope to represent for young girls out there that want to be the next Annie Agar?
That's a great point. You know, I want to show them that it's okay to be comfortable in the sports industry, and I think humor is a great way of doing that. Because instead of having to feel like you prove yourself to men or to anybody in general, you know, humor is a great way to showcase your knowledge, but without like kind of shoving it in people's face. So I think that's hopefully what I want to show them is it's okay to be funny and be in sports and be a content creator. It's a very, very fun industry. So
it's worked out very well.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. I'm trying.
I love it. And Annie, one of the big storylines this week, of course, is Taylor Swift coming to the big game to support her boo, Travis Kelsey. Do you feel like the Taylor Swift integration in the National Football League has been good for football?
I think for the people that aren't so familiar with the NFL, I mean, look at the viewership of all these games. Everybody's talking about this Super Bowl. I think in that aspect, yeah. And I know a lot of people like to hate on it, you know, but if they're happy, then what are we going to say about that? I'm glad they're happy. Yeah, exactly.
I love it. Annie, thank you so much for your time. We hope you enjoy the party.
Thank you so much. Of course. Thanks.
Kelsey Nicole Nelson back here on the red carpet, Babes in Toyland. Playmakers Party with none other than Colts linebacker EJ Speed. EJ, how are you enjoying the night thus far?
It's cool, man. It's great vibes out here. I see everybody got on their best. I love when people dress up and smile, have a few drinks, and just enjoy life.
And talking about the best, we see the chain that you're rocking, right?
Yeah, this is actually a Zoe Frost exclusive, man. He custom made this piece for me. Shout outs to him also.
Nice, love it. So of course this is a fun week for many players. We're leading up to Super Bowl 58. What fun festivities have you gotten into thus far?
Not too much. I just landed this today, but I went to the interception dinner, and now I'm here. Like I said, Vegas, I mean, I feel like this is the best Super Bowl I've been through. I've been in the league 6 years.
Nice.
This is the best one I've been to, for sure.
Let's talk about the Colts season thus far. What are you hoping to improve on for next year?
Next year, I mean, of course, just making it to the dance, just like we all are playing for. We'll get our quarterback back, and everything will be cool. I think our defense made good strides. We're getting our defensive coordinator back and Gus Bradley. Just expect big things from us next year, for sure.
Yeah. The AFC, lots of competition, as we saw this year, right, leading to the AFC Championship football game. How would you describe the Colts' identity?
Just tough, gritty, never giving up, always striving for that next step. We got great guys in the locker room that got a lot of heart. So I'm always excited to play with those guys, and I'm sure they're excited to play with me.
Very exciting. And last but not least, we know the NFL Honors just took place. Were there any upsets, people that you were rooting for at the award show?
Actually, I thought Maz Crosby should have got more love, but I'll shout out to Myles Garrett. He's a great athlete, too, and he did his thing. So well deserved for Myles Garrett, but it can only be one winner.
Only could be one winner. Thank you so much, EJ, for your time. What's next from you? I heard you have new music or something, right?
Nah, I got a podcast called The Trenches.
Okay,
called The Trenches. I'm sorry, I didn't even shout it out. But me, one of my teammates, Zaire Franklin, which was the Walter Payton Man of the Year for us this year.
Okay.
Tim, Jada, we started a podcast called The Trenches, just some guys coming from the bottom and working their way up into life, career, goals, wherever. We talk about all stuff related, celebrity news, football, or whatever like that, just everyday stuff in our life. It's taking off. We got an episode dropping tomorrow at 9 a.m., which is a great one. So tune in at The Trenches on Instagram and Twitter.
Perfect. EJ, thank you so much for your time.
Appreciate you.
Kelsey Nicole Nelson back here on the red carpet with Mr. Dillon. First off, how are you enjoying the night thus far?
Tonight's been amazing, honestly. I've never experienced anything like this. It's been a lifetime experience, so I'm honored to be here.
Let's talk about sports in the city of Vegas. It continues to grow. Formula One, now Super Bowl, right? Very exciting.
Yes. Honestly, I've been playing basketball my whole life and sports around Vegas my whole life, so I feel like the level of competition, just Vegas in general, it's known for gambling and it's high, like, prices of like everything. It's just Vegas has grown, like, not only like with money wise but also like athletically and like nationally. Yeah,
nice. And I know you play basketball, and I know the Las Vegas Aces have been embraced here. How would you feel basketball continues to grow in Vegas?
Honestly, with them continuing to like have teams join them with the Raiders and the Aces, I honestly think they should have more NBA teams out here and WNBA teams out here. So they should honestly keep continuing to like populate Vegas and just keep continuing to grow it.
And talking about basketball, aren't you on a TV show, right?
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about the TV show.
So my TV show, it started my freshman year in high school. I go to Sierra Canyon High School, and it started, so it's basically about our lives and what we do on a day-to-day basis. So it talks about us, what we do at practice, on the road games, on trips. So it's basically like a day-in-day life of a Sierra Canyon basketball player.
Very excited. So Sierra Canyon is a school we've gotten to know very well, of course, Bronny James and some others. Talk about that basketball team and how that identity has helped you to grow.
That basketball team was amazing. Getting to know those friends and connections has helped me not only with like my life, but like they're friends forever. So continuing to make those connections and meeting those people is amazing for me.
Awesome. Thank you so much for your time. Truly appreciate
you.
Back on the red carpet, we had to bring Dylan back because he is a member of Howard University's men's basketball team. Let's talk about the importance of HBCU basketball and Howard's season thus far.
Well, the importance of HBCU basketball, I feel like it helps the black men, honestly, like, we've been like put down our whole lives. We haven't been looked at the same. So HBCU gives us a chance to put out our talents and put out like what we're made of. Like black men are amazing. They could do anything's possible if they put their minds to it. So HBCU just honestly helps us grow and helps us build those connections.
I love that. And so as we look at Howard University basketball, what's next from Howard's men's team? Are we looking for championships?
Oh, no. We're definitely going to win the MEAC championship and definitely looking forward to make our second March Madness run.
I love that. Thank you so much, Dylan, for your time. Truly appreciate
Thank you.